So this what that question is very near and dear to my heart as a former principal. I started the answer to answer that question with teachers. Over the course of this planning year, multiple meetings with teacher groups. Here is some of the things that they told me. We want to be compensated. Those of us who are working hard and we're getting the results, we want to be compensated. We want a great leader. We want great professional development. We want to be treated like professionals. And we want opportunities to expand our career pathways, but not necessarily leave the classroom. We don't all aspire to be principals, but we don't want to be stuck in this one-dimensional role as I go in my room every day and teach 25 kids. So around that feedback, here are some of the things that we have done. We are bringing teachers back August 6th through the 15th, which is way earlier than CMS will bring teachers back, for a week and a half of professional development and planning time. So some of that will be around some of the urban, working with kids in urban poverty training that I talked about earlier. Some of that will be the technology training. A lot of that will be around reading instruction, because our kids can't read. But some of those days will be spent going in my classroom and get set up for the year and plan so that when the kids hit the floor on the first day, we're ready to go and we're not scrambling. The teachers are loving that idea. They're going to get paid to do it. It's not... I haven't said it's mandated, but it's very strongly encouraged that they all participate. They're excited. Something else that I've done is I found the best teachers in those schools, and when CMS announced it was having a transfer fair, I immediately engaged those teachers with a retention bonus because I did not want them to leave. I didn't want them to shop around. We are doing also a very rigorous interview process because we can't fire teachers. I mean, you know, we're in a box around that, and it takes a long time, but what a principal can control is who they're letting in the door, and we have to do a better job around that. So every teacher that has been hired in our zone so far, and let me say this because I'm proud of it, in March we had 170 vacancies, today we have 34, and by the end of July we expect to have zero. So we have had wide range of interest in coming to our schools, which I don't think has ever happened before. But we are interviewing around 5 turnaround competencies specifically. All of our teachers coming into our schools have to go through about an hour and a half pre-interview before the principal even sees them. And they have to score a certain amount around those turnaround competencies before they can go on in the process. We're also working with new leaders in the traditional sense. So some of our schools will have a resident principal, but what we're also looking to do next year is to identify 40 to 50 high-performing teachers and give them some adult leadership training so that they can begin to support principals and assistant principals as teacher leaders in their building. And it opens up opportunities for them to be deans, facilitators. They can lead as one teacher, a small group of 4 or 5 teachers in a pod type environment. They can lead their department more effectively. So we're looking for ways to really expand career pathways for teachers so they don't feel locked into the classroom or the only option is I have to be a principal. We're also providing for our teachers next year a teacher innovation grant that they can apply for. I'm prepared to give every teacher a grant. Hopefully most teachers will apply, that they can identify something that they're passionate about and we will fund that in their classroom. So if they want to do a community garden and do that through their science classroom, they can be funded to do that, which goes back to some of the relevancy that we've talked about. How are we tying what we do in a classroom to the real world? So those are just a few examples. I don't know if I hit on enough for you there.
Maybe have a chance you can say how you're
identifying
those good teachers.
Okay, we're using several different things. Data when it's available, evaluations, and right now working through some other ways such as teacher attendance. It's hard to really like identify what makes for a good teacher because it's such an art. It's a science, but it's also an art. And so it's going to just take multiple conversations to get that. I think that's what the state struggles with when we start talking about performance pay. Like, how do we really do that? We don't have a specific answer right now. But I don't think we should stop trying because we don't have an answer. I think we should keep trying to answer that question. Yes, ma'am. I agree. I agree with you, and what I will say is you're absolutely right. We need to do a better job around that. Part of Project L.I.F.T. will do that, but I'm also going to say that we as a community and as parents have to do a better job. Schools can give information, but to get it, you have to be in a position to receive it. I also want to encourage our parents. I just spoke with a parent yesterday, and she was apologizing for advocating for her child to the point that it's frustrated the teacher, and the teacher's mad. I said, ma'am, you don't apologize for that. You don't apologize for that. That's what you should be doing. We have got to get our parents to understand that they have to be at the door, knocking. What is out there? I want to be a part of putting their kids in positions to take a position, a part of it. It's a school responsibility, it's a community. It's a dual responsibility. Here is my office phone number. If you, it's 343-0900. When the person calls, though, this is the number one thing I need for them to tell me. What do they want to do to help? A lot of times I get phone calls and people just say, I want to help. And then I'm trying to figure out how to make them have a good experience.
Do we have a contact person? I mean, besides you, I mean, I know your schedule. Is there an alumni person that they can, you know what I'm saying? I know you have some people that work with you with alumni, but I mean, you would think.
So when we hire a community engagement coordinator, I'm hoping that person will be helpful in that regard. I can also say people can contact the schools directly. Daisy Walker is sitting here. Daisy, tell them what you do at West Charlotte High School.
Yes.
Your whole job.
That's right. I'm glad to hear you say that. I want my back to you. I'm the volunteer coordinator in West Charlotte, and I have a potpourri of list of volunteers that I send out regularly. Right now, I send out a list on probably when we started the summer program for graduates, and I think I've got 5 responses. Five. People, we need tutors in math and science. I send it out regularly. So if you, I need you to get in contact with me, and I can tell you what you can do. Because there is plenty to do at West Charlotte. Plenty.
And her salary is Project L.I.F.T. funded, and she earns every cent of it.
Every cent is somebody else's.
Yes, she does.
So we need you there at West Charlotte, and please give me your name. And the alumni, I talk to them all the time. They have the same people coming. And I have a long list. When you go into Charlotte Mecklenburg's website, it says West Charlotte has approximately 1,190 volunteers that have signed up. That is not true. The names are there, but their bodies are not in West Charlotte. So when I send it out regularly asking for volunteers, I'm getting the same few people. So there is plenty to do. I am there waiting, begging people to come in. We have a lot of partners who are working. But I don't have enough of West Charlotte alumni coming in. We need you. So my name is Daisy Walker.
So those things are obviously a part of the regular school curriculum. What has happened over the last few years as CMS has had to cut the budget, some of those teacher positions have been cut. Some of those positions are now coming back. Teachers realize the importance of having those teachers in their buildings. So we will begin to rebuild a arts program.
That's
in that way.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.